this is Control.
Control, this is Hawk Bravo. We are green across the board. Five on voice, five on chat.
As one of the Army's primary technology and system integrators, the Combat Capabilities Development Command's C5ISR Center demonstrates persistent modernization by bringing developing technologies out of the laboratory and demonstrating them in simulated operational environments early and often during the development cycle. This kind of experimentation, combined with soldier feedback, can change the capability development trajectory and lead to a more robust, flexible, and relevant solution when the technology is ready for operational testing. During the annual Network Modernization Experiment, or NetModX, engineers assess how technologies at various levels of maturity perform during a series of threat-based scenarios and in a variety of tactical environments.
NetModX allows us to bring together subject matter experts, industry partners, and the end user, the soldier, to help inform future requirements development so that we can provide as a community the soldier with new and novel ways of defending our country. And in the end, as we work through all the data analysis and all of the requirements gathering, we aim through this event to help provide our soldiers with the equipment that they need to succeed in the future.
This approach enables C5ISR Center engineers and industry technology developers to learn how emerging technologies function in a real-world scenario, to evaluate capability gaps and adjust course as needed to improve functionality, and to ensure we are providing the technology and capabilities the U.S. Army needs to maintain the world's dominant ground combat force.
NetModX directly supports the Army's tactical network modernization strategy, which focuses on rapid prototyping and experimentation in support of four lines of effort: developing a unified network, creating a common operating environment, improving joint and coalition interoperability, and improving the mobility and survivability of Army command posts. Findings from this experiment provide real data and assessment for Army leaders to inform requirements development and provide critical input to the network cross-functional team and program executive office teammates who are responsible for driving the fielding of new capabilities.
We love to have soldiers come in and take a look at a technology because in the end, soldiers have a great unique viewpoint and they have unique experiences that if they're given those opinions early in the technology's development, it can shape the way a technology develops from here forward.
Closer look at NetModX 20 provides an idea of the size, scope, and outcomes of the experiment, which include shaping and influencing the time frame for delivering next-generation Army network capabilities.
NetModX has been pretty great. We come out here every morning, we gear up with the technology, we get a brief on the technology before we actually start using it. We take data down as we do things, depending on what the technology is, and then from there, we provide input to hopefully make it slightly better for the soldiers when they do receive it.
During the 2020 experiment, C5ISR Center scientists and engineers assessed more than 30 technologies focused on improving warfighters' communications capabilities and safeguarding the Army's networks. Capabilities included non-traditional waveforms, protected satellite communications, defensive cyber, and command post cyber survivability. In the category of non-traditional waveforms, soldiers tested capabilities that provide dismounted soldiers with reach back to the platoon level and higher by incorporating affordable technologies for voice and data communications with low probability of intercept, low probability of detection, and anti-jamming capabilities.
The importance of the squad area network is to provide the dismount with a voice and data communication system at a low cost out in the field. Currently, the soldiers do not have this capability. Bringing it out here in NetModX has allowed us to demonstrate this capability and see the benefits of the usage of the capability.
Squad area network, it's basically an improved radio for inter-squad use. Essentially, you have a set of team radios with a team leader, obviously, and then the squad leader radio, which can override if the squad leader needs to talk. So essentially, I think it'll help a lot with inter-squad communications. It runs pretty well so far.
In addition to testing squad area network capabilities, NetModX provided government and industry engineers with a chance to test non-traditional waveforms in various field environments using the Dismount Distributed Tactical Beamforming System.
The Dismount Distributed Tactical Beamforming System is targeted at providing very low-cost radios that are highly resilient to interference, very hard to detect, and provide the warfighter with a radio that's unprecedented for decades and decades. Prior to this capability, the soldiers operating at squad and below, platoon and below, often are using hand signals in order to communicate with each other in a wartime environment. The Dismount Distributed Tactical Beamforming System enables a warfighter with communications at a very low echelon that is very affordable, lightweight, and resilient, and enables them to perform operations in ways that they may not have been able to foresee now that each warfighter can have a radio at their availability.
The Army's Protected Satellite Communications effort focuses on capabilities that improve the resiliency of SATCOM technologies and protect soldier-to-soldier communications from both friendly and adversarial interference.
The Army relies on long-range communications to win on the tactical battlefield. Our Protected SATCOM effort researches and develops technologies to make wideband SATCOM resilient. This allows the Army to operate in a contested and congested environment.
Interference cancellation is part of the Protected SATCOM suite of equipment, which allows continuous communication in an electromagnetically contested environment. During NetModX 19, we utilized a state-of-the-art commercially available solution, which had many promising strengths and also a few weaknesses. During NetModX 20, we used an in-house S&T-developed effort, which built on many of the strengths of the commercial state-of-the-art solution, as well as addressing many of the weaknesses to overcome the challenges that we could not overcome during NetModX 19.
Virtual diversity provides seamless access to soldier communication. It helps maintain connectivity by using all the available paths. If one of the paths is going down, it switches the communication to the other available path. Virtual diversity is implemented in software to help reduce costs. It is important as we look to leverage the emerging communication system to add resiliency to the network.
Engineers tested defensive cyber software capabilities that provide soldiers the assistance they need to detect, protect, and mitigate compromised tactical networks on the battlefield and improve their ability to make informed cyber decisions.
Our C5ISR cybersecurity research and development projects are securing and protecting the future tactical networks and ensuring that we can defend against any cybersecurity attacks. And when we cannot, we want to assure that we can securely reestablish and maintain the network and fight through those cyber attacks.
Focused efforts included autonomous cyber and information trust, which allows soldiers to proactively defend the Army's network against adversaries and validate the information that passes through the network originates from trusted sources.
We're testing two technologies within the autonomous cyber program. The first technology, called CTAD, was designed to identify specific behaviors on the network to feed alerts to cyber defenders. The second technology was BrokerML, ZeroML. This technology was a way for us to automate the ingestion to training pipeline of machine learning technologies. So these technologies, the behavioral network analytics tech, is going to help cyber defenders respond to attacks in real time and defend the network at machine speed and lessen the burden on our warfighters. The BrokerML, ZeroML technology is going to give us a way to deliver machine learning capabilities out to the field quicker with less human interaction.
At NetModX, we were testing blockchain capabilities in a tactical environment for the Information Trust Program. Implementing blockchain technology in a tactical environment allows a soldier to have data provenance where we can track the information they care about from producer to consumer and really validate that that data has not been tampered with in order to prevent the commanding officer from acting on malicious information.
The ability to avoid detection is a major requirement for the Army's future command posts. Soldiers tested dispersed command post technologies and radio frequency signature management and provided feedback during NetModX.
utilizing millimeter wave for NetModX. Essentially, this is going to be a capability that United States Army is able to use for quick comms when we set up and tear down. It gives us the ability to not use as many wires in a smaller infrastructure and overall a better and smaller signature as well.
The work to identify, test, and militarize robust communications is critical for command post dispersion and mobility. Our goal is to help the Army determine which system specifications are needed to provide an effective operational capability so they can decide which to procure.
Although the focus changes every year, the overarching outcomes of NetModX remain the same.
NetModX is an excellent opportunity for our C5ISR Center research and development projects to follow the AFC requirements to test early and often.
Analysts also identify potential vulnerabilities in government and industry systems that undergo assessment at NetModX. System developers can then mitigate vulnerabilities before the technology is fielded, ensuring adversaries don't have the opportunity to exploit them. Data gathered during the experiment is used to evaluate the technological readiness of the capabilities by comparing them against the 9 readiness levels used to describe the maturity of Department of Defense technologies. These readiness levels are used to determine whether or not the capability meets the requirements for the next developmental phase, a soldier touchpoint. Industry partners operating under previously established cooperative research and development agreements obtain insight regarding how their technologies perform in an operationally relevant environment. Feedback enables developers to adjust and improve systems prior to the acquisition process, ultimately resulting in better capabilities delivered to soldiers.
In order to be able to add capabilities to the network rapidly, we must bridge the gap between industry technology developers and the end users, the soldiers, who provide feedback on operational relevance and user-friendly design. NetModX provides a key opportunity for that dialogue to occur. The result? Better value for the Army and improved capabilities delivered in a much shorter timeframe. By harnessing innovation from industry, adapting commercially available products, and conducting experiments in an operationally relevant environment, the C5ISR Center enables the network cross-functional team and the Army acquisition community to make informed decisions, clarify requirements, reduce procurement timelines, and quickly deliver new and enhanced capabilities to the men and women in the field.
Through NetModX and other experiments that facilitate continuous learning, the C5ISR Center shapes capabilities and solutions that support an Army ready to deploy, fight, and win decisively against any adversary, anytime, and anywhere.